Amen. God bless you in Jesus' name. Shall I pray? Father, I thank you, your word is coming. Use me as a vessel to your people. Let me speak by divine oracles. Let me speak by divine intention in the name of the Lord. I pray that, Lord, use me to be a blessing in the name of Jesus. I pray. Let the people of God say amen.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Something is about to happen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Can't you feel that God has visited us right now?
Amen.
I feel strong anointing upon my spirit.
Amen.
Oh, somebody say amen.
Amen.
I feel it. Hallelujah. I want you to focus on the word that is coming. And I want you to know that God is about to lead you to a different level.
Amen.
At times, if you don't have the word of God, you give up in life. If you don't know where you are going, you get tired on the road. When Samson knew where he was going, because that time he needed a woman, he wanted to marry. So along the way, when he was going, Bible said a lion came on his way. The lion could have stopped Samson to return back. The lion could have scared Samson to give up on his journey. But Samson saw something ahead and said, I have to battle my lion. Say, I'll battle my lion. In life, anytime you are going to receive something powerful, a lion will appear. Until you deal with that lion, you can never get the miracle you are looking for. The lions can appear in so many different dimensions. But don't give up. Someone say, don't give up.
Don't give up.
You must have the attitude of perseverance. Because when a woman gets pregnant, automatically, by 9 months, the baby will come. So don't abort your baby. Someone say, don't abort your baby. Because of the pain. Say, I will not abort my baby, because of the pain. I want to build your spirit, build your mind, and I want to infuse something into your spirit. Because the Lord wants to do something. But if you don't have eyes, you don't see. Praise the Lord. Bible said, Martha saw Nazareth that he is dead. But Jesus saw that Nazareth was sleeping.
Amen.
Praise God. So Martha gave up. Martha's faith died. Because all that Martha knew was that his brother is dead. But Jesus also knew or knows that Nazareth is just sleeping. So I have to go and wake him up. Today the Lord is here to do something in your life. But I want you to have faith in him that he is able, he's a miracle working God. There's a way that is keeping me and moving me forward. That the Lord told me that I will lift you and I will send you to places. And I, the Lord, will work a miracle. So before God will make a miracle, there should be a mess. I get what I'm saying? There should be a mess. There should be a scatter. There should be a dirty something, so that God in that midst will work a miracle out of what we're going through.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, let me go on to the message today. You know, yesterday we were here, we prayed, we spent some time in prayer, we're talking to God, anyone that spent time with God can stand against any situations.
Amen.
Are you with me? I need your attention. Anytime you spend time with God, you can be able to handle. Someone say handle. No, I can't hear your voice. Someone say handle. You can be able to handle situations. People has money. Some people have a lot of money, but they cannot handle situation and they kill themselves. Some go and hang themselves. Some go and commit suicide. Some misbehave. Because the energy to go through, they don't have it.
Yes.
Huh? We thank God for the life of Job. What Job went through, if Job doesn't know who God is, he would have given up. Am I right? But Job saw another breakthrough ahead of what he was going through. So if don't go through, don't have breakthrough. Am I right? See, if God wants to give you big testimony, he will create big tests. Or if you want to clap, you can clap for Jesus. When God wants to give you something big, me, where I see myself, it's too big for me to deny my God. Because where I see God taking me and taking what place to, it is too powerful. For trials and persecutions and attack will bring me down. Someone say no. My God. The message that God gave to me is that you have to allow him to work on you. Someone say allow. The Lord to work on you. God bless you. I'm going to go deep because it's a message. Message is what God has told you to tell his people. So when you listen to the voice of God, it transforms your life. Not when you go to church. It's not when you go to all night. It's when you listen to his word. Because a lot of people are in churches, but they are being covered. I went to preach somewhere, and some people came to me, and the way they were saying, I saw that. So they have been in church for years, but yes, though they have never any encounter divine connectivity. They are dying, they are sick, they complain as if God is not there. No, you see, it's about time you yourself must whoop. Walk with the word of God. Personal encounter.
Amen. Amen.
Because everything can fail you. Your husband can fail you. Your wife can fail you. Your pastor can fail you. But Jesus never fails. Oh, the government can fail you. Even your money can fail you.
My Lord.
Your Lord will never fail you. Your boyfriend can fail you. So when I see people that they don't have time for God, but they have time for their boyfriends, and I just pity them. You are giving your time to something that Bible says don't put your trust upon it.
Amen.
And you see, that's why people are frustrated and hurt and disturbed, and they want to end their life. Give your whole trust and life to God.
Amen.
If you can trust God, if you can love him, then the Lord can give you somebody who can also handle you.
Yes.
Somebody say, talk to me.
Talk to me.
Somebody say, talk to me.
Talk to me.
Am I talking to somebody?
Yes.
Unless you allow him to work on you.
Amen.
Now, let me go. God respects the willpower of human, of a man. God respects it. Because he's not an altar of confusion.
Yes.
Are you with me? God doesn't contract it himself. So when I begin to see, like some prophet, this one was, now I've seen two prophets prophesying the name of God to one particular person, and different, you know, this one say yes, this one say God has to tell you no. Hallelujah. It happens in Ghana. That one prophet will be saying this one is going to win. This one will say this one is going to win. The same thing. That is when, this is why we must grow in the things of God in order for us to hear God by our side.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
I get what I'm saying. You must grow in the things of God so that when God speaks, you can analyze it.
Yes.
Now let me say this before I go to the word. When your daughter speaks, you know that even if you don't see her, you recognize her voice.
Amen.
If I'm speaking and you are outside, you know that this is international preacher.
Yes.
He's the one preaching. Because you recognize my voice. The reason that we cannot hear God's speech is that we don't even give our life to Him. So when God speaks, we can't even hear. So people's life has been messed by false predictions. Someone say amen.
Amen.
So, in order for God to work in your life, you must allow Him. I said, God doesn't force people. God will not force you to pray. God will not force you to eat. Because He has given you something called your willpower. You choose what you want to wear today. God doesn't decide that for you. Praise God. You can choose to come to church and you can decide not to come. That is your willpower and God respect that. So God will not come that I want to make you rich. Anytime you see God talking to somebody, there's always the word if. There's always a principle of instructions. I get what I'm saying. God will not give you a man because you need a man. Unless you allow Him to give you a man. And before you can allow God, you must submit to him. I want to be the point here. So that it is not how long you have been in the church. It's not about the powerful, big auditorium. That's where you get your miracle. This is where a lot of people are getting it wrong. Because it's Sunday, I have to go to church. That's it. So what are you yourself, what are you benefiting? What is the impact? Because at the end of the day, everybody is going to give his own account to God differently. We are not going to call this church come for judgment. No! You have to realize certain things by yourself. Someone say, talk to me. You must allow Him. God will never force you. God doesn't force humanity. So the willpower must be submissive to God before God can able to do something with your life. It's a choice. It's a choice. I can, even though God has called me, but I can decide not to do His way. So for God to use me, I must allow myself. So it was allowed. So I must allow and avail my life, my time, my heart for Him so that He, the Lord, can work through me.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. If I don't allow God to work through me, there's no way God can force me to do it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to give you a message that today you allow yourself for God to let you. Allow yourself to get to where God has designed for you. Allow yourself to be a blessing because God doesn't force anyone.
Amen. Amen.
He doesn't force you.
Amen.
And it is not by force that as you have come to check, God must work a miracle for you. You must allow yourself for miracle.
Yes.
I get what I said. You must allow yourself, even deliverance, it is a choice. Somebody can decide, I don't want to come out from this place. I want to be in this situation. I don't want to surrender my life. Now let us go into the scriptures. In the book of Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19, I would like a reader, please. Isaiah, the book of prophet Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19. I want to give a word here, so please. Somebody should read for us. We need a reader to read the word of God to us. Isaiah chapter 1, the verse 19. Who is there for me, please? Is somebody there?
If ye be willing and obedient, ye shall eat the good of the land.
Now, listen to the word of God properly. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
So when people see, prayer is very, very good, but you must know how to pray.
Amen.
He said, if you are hot, please can you read for me? If what?
If ye be willing and obedient.
Now, God said, if you are willing, so for somebody to be blessed, for somebody to break through. you, for somebody to become great, you must be willing. When a woman doesn't, is not willing to marry, you can, if you pray billions prayer, it will never work. You see, we have let religious doctrine has bring a lot of conflict, and people talk anyhow because of things that we have been said. So it's about that truth, because the only thing that can liberate you is the truth. God said, if you are willing, and the Lord have made the provisions, and the Lord am able to do everything to cause miracle to happen, because I am God. But for me to give you abundance, for you to eat the fruit of the land, for you to become blessed in Canada, to buy your own houses, start your own business, you must allow God to work on you. You must allow him. People have not given their life to God, but they want God to work on, to use them all, or to be a blessing to. It will never work. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As for the word Christianity, everybody can say it.
Yes.
Anybody is a word that anybody can say, I'm a Christian. Mm-hmm. Am I right?
Yes.
But to become is the difference.
Yes.
To say, but to practice.
Yes.
If you are willing, the word if means is a condition, and it's not by force. So I can choose that, hey, I just want to live on social. People have chosen in this country to live on social. They've chosen. I get what I'm saying. I get what I'm coming from. People have chosen. He said, if you are willing and obedient. So for God to work, for you to be a blessing on the land, you must be willing. Willing means you are desiring. You have every desire to become that thing. So you are willing. Number two, and if you obey, so it is going to be an instruction. God will never make you a billionaire if you have not allowed him to instruct you. Because blessing is a property. Blessing is what? So God will never, can you give your property to someone who cannot handle it? Now let us be frank to ourselves. Can you give your property to someone who cannot handle it? No. So praying for money, financial breakthrough, doesn't mean that God must give you financial breakthrough, because there are conditions and there will be an instruction. Because God wouldn't give you much if it is all about you alone. So if you don't have the love, if you don't have the heart that you can support the poor, you look after people, you support the things of God. Brother, sister, stop praying for breakthrough. For that, God doesn't work that way.
Amen.
Allow him. So if you are willing, if, so there's a cross there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you can give your life to me, if you can be obedient, if you can serve me, if you can be prayerful, if you can be submissive, if you listen to my word, that when I give you strength and you work and have money, if you can give me the 10%, that I the Lord will open the front gate of heaven. If you can be obedient to it, that I the Lord will pour out. So if you know and you are not obedient, sister, forget.
Amen.
Forget about miracle, forget about breakthrough, forget about greatness, because you must allow God to work on you.
Amen.
Praise God. For me, I am allowing God to use me to do whatever he the Lord want to do in my life. So I must avail, I must pray, search the scriptures, read and study, and be in prayer and love the people of God so that God can continue.
Amen.
I preach somewhere, I don't want to mention the name of the church. It's one of the popular churches in this country, and I went down and preached, and they said they have never seen or heard anywhere like this before. What the people is saying, it's a man of God, we have been here listening to word, but your word have turned us to a different person. We have never. When I heard this word, I became more humble and I give praise to God.
Amen.
Because God wouldn't use you because he has called you. You must allow him to work through you. Now, let me say this. David could not have been able to kill Goliath just because he's David. Do you know why? He allowed God to train him. Oh, hallelujah. He allowed God to train him in the wilderness. God said, I have a great mission for him. There's something ahead of you, but I have to send you to train. Someone say training. And this is what people doesn't want to go through. People doesn't want to go through the training, the system, the procedure for them to get to the top. They want shortcut. A lot of pastors, if it doesn't want God to work on them, they will shortcut. So people do sick many days to get there. People, some kill, some do rituals, some perform demonic things just to win the people. They don't want to wait on God. They don't want to pray. They don't want to fast. They don't want to go through the process as I am going through now. Do you know I'm going through my process of time? He's preparing me, preparing my mind, preparing my energy, preparing my spirit for something great ahead of time. So I must allow him. So let's allow him. Allow him. Allow God to work on you. I'm going to prove in my scriptures so that it's not about everybody that will come to church and have a testimony. Some will be coming to church, they will never have a testimony. Some will be going to prayer, they will never be healed. All because they don't allow. They don't allow. And allowing, I'm going to prove how, why, and how you can allow God to begin to take center of your time. Yes. Then you can begin to see God act in your life.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. Yes. You can never commit your life to Jesus. And Jesus will seek to read that it will be destroyed. No. Someone say no.
No.
When I see people, you know, some things, God, you see, God doesn't work that way, sister. God doesn't, Bible says, the Lord takes delight in the pleasure of his people. The Lord rejoices over the pleasure of his people. That is why I said, I won't take my people from Egypt. They are suffering. They are going through hell. I want them to go to a place where they have the liberty to praise me. So the intentions of God in your life is to send you to a place where you can have peace of mind. But before you can get there, allow God to work on you. Because even some wanted to go back to Egypt. Do you know that? God, so when you are leading people, there are few, and there are few people who are following what you are saying. Others are just listening to you. They have different in their mind.
Yeah.
It's not what you are saying. They just have different stuff. Praise the Lord. So they were following Moses, but they have Egyptian mentality. They don't want to allow themselves for deliverance. So when trials appear, you see, people demonstrate what they have taught and what they have in their mind when difficult things happen. Are you getting what I'm saying? When difficult things happen, that is when you see people demonstrating and bringing out what they have in their mind. All and out along, and when they were going, in their mind, they loved the food of the Egyptians. In their mind, they want to serve the gods of the Egyptians, but they were going, but in their mind. So when they saw the Red Sea, and they said, wow, this is the opportunity for us to show that we don't want to go to Canaan. We don't love Canaan. We want to still be under our slave masters. We want to still be controlled by our slave masters. We want to serve our slave masters. We want them to control us so that we will not have time for our God. So Moses, this is the clear evidence that we want to go back. You don't want to allow themselves. Sister, allow God to work on you. Now let's go into the scriptures again. Revelation chapter 3 verse 20. Jesus can only come to your life if you are open your door.
Yeah.
So when miracle hits your life, you must allow yourself for miracle to hit you. Because I can go to a place and still not believe what's happening. I will lock my spirit, and anything that goes there, I don't even care. Because I don't want to allow myself to be delivered.
Yes.
Amen.
Revelation 3 verse 20. Can someone read for us? Revelation, the book of Revelation, chapter 3 verse 20. Please, if we are there, let's flow. Yes. Now, Jesus said, behold, I cannot force into your door. I cannot come and say, receive me. I cannot force you to live your bad life. He said, behold, I stand at the door. It's a sign that God respects the power of humanity.
Yes.
So if we don't submit to him, if you don't allow ourselves, God, Jesus will not come to our life. That's why to receive Jesus, you confess it. It's a decision taking. Because you are going to drop everything that you are doing. And I will talk about the meaning of submission. He said, behold, I stand at where? Your door. What is it that Jesus said? I'm coming to your door by force to come and take you. Because if you are not ready, you can't be used. If you are not ready, you can't serve. If you are not ready, you cannot humble. If you are not ready, you can never wait. Because we're not ready.
Yes.
Is somebody catching revelation?
Yes.
Oh, no. Is somebody here that is catching a revelation?
Yes.
Let me see my hands. Who are catching revelation?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
They were catching something.
Yes.
I want you to live here with something.
Yes.
I'm telling you. He says, behold, I stand at your door. Please, let's go.
If anyone hears my voice and opens the door,
Jesus, he said, behold, I stand at the door. If, oh my God. You see, anytime God wants to do something, he brings away what? If. God wants you to accept. He said, if anyone hears my voice, if. It means it can be of your own choice whether to ignore when God is speaking. Get yourself easy. Get yourself out of the word of God, because you don't want to be refined. So I stand at your door. If you open, now I say, if you hear my voice and open, then I, the Lord, will come in. So God will not come into your marriage because you are a Christian, though. He will come into your marriage, your business, your finance, your life, if you allow him. If you open your heart, because there are a lot of things in people's heart would not allow God to live in them. If I went to rent a house, and when you go, there are things already there, will you live there? You will not stay there, because there are things occupied already. You cannot live there. So if you want Jesus to come to your life, you must open your door. If you want to be rich, if you want to be anointed, if you want to see spiritual things, if you want to become a blessing to many nations, if you want to become a role model, you must allow yourself so that God can work on you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. We don't just pray that I want to become this, but we work to become.
Amen.
I get what I'm saying. Amen. We don't just pray, I want to be a rich man. You have to work. So there will be instructions. That's why the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 is saying, if my people can listen and diligently seek, you know, follow my ways and pay this and this, I, the Lord, is going to do this. So before God even will come and be a blessing and bless you and give you a man or give you a child and give you this, you must begin to obey him. You must begin to listen to him. You must follow his instructions. You must love him. You must drop your own attitude aside and begin to follow him. Then the Lord, is there anything too hard for the Lord?
Amen. Amen.
And my house, I will receive a call. Man of God, we are starting this television. Tomorrow I'm going to preach on one of the television. Tuesday, one of the big radio stations in Jamaica has connected to me. Man of God, we want to see when you allow yourself, God will open doors from afar. Because people are looking for where they can be saved.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. Some pastor doesn't want to wait anymore. They don't want to go through the hard times like the wife of Job. They are sick and tired. They say, yes, God, if God can do it, why should I lie to me in this mess? Hallelujah. God wants you to go through the mess so that he can give you messages. So that he can give you a message. Say, my messages will turn to messages. So that when you take a mic and you are talking to people, you know what I'm talking about. You are telling evidence. If I've not gone through it, you can never teach it. You become a theory man. And when people are in theory Christianity, they don't see the power of God. Unless you have been a practical, you have given and you are seeing the giving back, you have been faithful to your time, and you are witnessing the abundance of breakthrough, you have been holy before God, and you are enjoying your life, because whatsoever you do, you shall it.
Yes.
So when you are somebody's husband, yes, when you marry, somebody will be on your husband.
Amen.
Oh, praise God.
Amen.
Allow God. After this wedding, go home and say, now God, I've allowed myself. Use me. Use me to be a blessing. People are dying. People need to hear the gospel. People are fed up. People are giving up. God wants you to allow yourself so that he can use you to go and deliver people. God was talking to Moses. He said, Moses, I want to use you to do this. Moses, I said, Moses was talking. I'm a son, I can't speak. He said, I'll give you this. God was in condition with Moses. He said, and Moses said, what will be the proof? He said, put the stick down. Intend to stay. He said, I cannot. I want to do it. Moses, give aloud. I want to do it. I want to use you. God is always looking for available flights to use. It's not, you see, if you are not avail your status, why? God sent Esther and vastly lost her royal glory. And God gave it to Esther. You see, when you can allow God to work on you, because Esther allowed Mordecai to teach her, to instruct her, to give her something, and Mordecai applied them, and lo and behold, God make a miracle. So if you are praying for something, allow God to instruct you. Follow his instructions.
Amen.
Follow his instructions. There's one lady that one of my covenant partners, and she called me. I called her yesterday. We were talking, and she's a man of God. Ever since I started doing this, I am seeing God.
Amen.
He didn't say ever since I started listen to following you. He said, ever since I start listening to what God says, I have experienced this, that God is working for me. Hey, you can be here and you can be billionaire more than your pastor.
Yes,
yes, of course. Because you have allowed yourself. Praise God.
Amen.
That's why some people get jealous. Like Saul. That, hey, how can I sit there for David, this small boy, to just have this praise? I'll kill him. There are a lot of people out of disobedience, they are killing people. They don't want their daughters even to write. I know mothers, some mothers, that doesn't want their daughters to get married. I'm telling you, these things, when you say it sound weird, like how? It is real. It is real, 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 real. I'm telling you. But if you can allow yourself, God will work a miracle in you. He said, I stand at your door. If you open, if you, big papa, if you can open your hand, God can use you to raise the dead. I listened to what the late Archbishop Inahosa, he went to a church, and the pastor preached about, he said, in Jesus' name, in my name, you cast out demons. In my name, you heal the sick. In my name, you raise the dead. And the late Archbishop Inahosa went to the man of God and said, man of God, have you raised the dead before? He said, no. And he said, can I raise the dead? He said, yes. The man went out looking for a dead body. Looking for, because he has heard it. And he said, I want to avail myself. Because pastors are preaching some mercy, but some of them doesn't practice it. They talk about love, but they don't love. They talk about giving, they don't give. They talk about holiness, they themselves are messed up.
Yes.
So you, when you listen and you practice it, you begin to encounter the miracle and the breakthrough and the favor. So when David allowed himself, at the time that Israel were looking for a deliverer, God simply moved to somebody whom the Lord has trained, whom he has allowed himself to be trained, and God used him.
Amen.
God can use you. Anybody to do whatever you want to do. Any available flight, he the Lord can use. Unless you allow him. Are you allowing God to talk to you? Or you want to do the way I want? Some people, they talk about, it's my life, I want to do whatever I want to do, sister. Then don't pray for certain things. God is not an automatic God. He's not a remote God. You can never remote him. Praise the Lord. You can't remote God. Someone say, talk to me. Now, another scripture. Now, before you can allow God, you must submit to him.
Amen.
You must have total submission. Now, what the meaning of submission? Is the act of allowing someone or something to have a power over you. It's an act of allowing. So you can choose not to allow. I get what I'm saying. You can choose to refuse to submit to God, and God will never mind you. You can refuse not to give offering, and God doesn't, because it is your own advantage. It is your own blessing. It's for your own miracle when you do it. So God wouldn't force you, but he's going to instruct you. He said, my son, if you can do this, if you can do it. Now, when Abraham was old, do you know that Abraham started complaining? When you read the Bible and you have the Spirit of God, you know Abraham started complaining, but in his mind, and God knows our mind. God said, I'm going to have a child. And ever since, look at my age, I have no child. Oh, thank God. So he started remembering his mind. And God appeared. He said, Abraham, walk before me. It is not by force for me to honor my word, but it is a condition. If you can walk before me, you cannot go to other gods. You cannot go to Opia. You cannot be in fornication and see the glory of God. No. He said, leave those things. Be blameless, Abraham. Be blameless. And I, the job is mine. Sister, the job for you to get there is God.
Amen.
Oh my God. Look at the people that came with them. I didn't even know that they are going to come.
Amen. Look at that.
Look at that. So, for the increase is from God.
Amen.
It's just a matter of time.
Yes, yes.
Be proper. It's just what? A matter of time.
Amen.
Oh my God, you are not here with me. It's just a matter of time.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord timing. It says, I have come to a level that is just a matter of time. If the Lord has brought me to this place, he will do whatever he has said. If the Lord would have done it, I would not even have the opportunity to come. Because people are praying, people are doing everything, working in banks, they apply, they don't give to them.
Yes.
I'm telling you, some come, they deport them.
Yes.
Some try, they die. So it's because God will do something.
Amen.
So God said, my son, I won't send you through this fire.
Amen.
I won't refine you. A gold, before a gold becomes gold, what does it do?
It goes through fire.
It goes through fire. The fire doesn't destroy gold. My God. So if you're a child of God and you get burnt in fire, you weren't a child of God. When fire days, you give up. When fire days, you can't pray to God. When fire days, you can't come to church. When fire days, you stop giving to God. You become sick and tired. You are not a gold. Go through the fire. In the midst of your trouble, begin to praise him. In the midst of accusation, where everything seems to be wrong, give him the praise, because he knows what he's doing.
Yeah.
He knows what he's doing. Somebody say, God knows what he's doing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that is the meaning of submissive. To allow is an act of allowing someone or something to have power over you.
Amen.
So you have to allow. So everything based on you. Praise God.
Amen.
Everything for you to be successful is based when you allow to follow the principles of God. Am I right? Oh, am I right? For God to use you is for you to allow yourself for him to use you. Because last I had a message, a prophetic message, and I thank you, I choose not to give. Do you know that people, those people that work at the post office, when they have, they can choose not to bring it to your boss. Some choose to throw it away. I'm telling you. So choose to throw it away, put it somewhere. Wrong places. They choose it. But for them to deliver this, have to follow instruction. Look unto the address. Talk it. Then you be the one can receive it. So when to follow principles, the receiving power will just come. Oh, I get what I'm saying. When you follow the principle, when you just follow it, God is in that miracle already.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. I said God is in that miracle already. He's in that process because you have allowed, you are following it. He's in that process.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
He's in already. But if you don't follow, then you know what happened? The devil takes control. Because anytime you miss God's track, you fall into the track of the enemy. Can I repeat again? Anytime you miss God's track, the next track is God's the devil's track. And when you fall in the devil's track, what does he do? He leads you to wrong places. You'll be meeting wrong people. You'll be meeting slack. Because the track that you are on is a wrong place. If you are going to have a thing and you have GPS and you put in US address, will it send it to Hamilton? You'll be driving and you'll be complaining. What am I going to get to Hamilton? I'm driving my Benny cars. Why? Because the address is wrong. You are on the wrong road. So you pay. That's why people are in places, they are not seeing God's glory. So when somebody begins to complain, ask him, what are you doing? Are you following the principles? Ask the person. He will tell you. Are you still in prayer? I met one man of God yesterday. He's a man of God. This and that. But keep praying.
Amen.
That's the word he told me.
That's it.
And before that, I've seen those two people. Anytime I enter to prayer, there are two particular people I see there. Always. Say anyone assigned to battle my life. Say fire. Now, he said, when you submit to him, the battle becomes the law. That is why nobody can able to defeat you. The devil has no power over your life because you have surrendered your life to him and the battle is him. So if somebody takes you to Obia, the person is about to die. Oh, I'm telling you. If you are giving your life to God, let me tell you, when they throw their arrows, God will allow the arrow to come. Then you see where the arrow was coming from. Then the Lord will return it back to the sender. That is why it will qualify. That only your eyes will you see, behold, the reward of your enemies. So God will allow the arrow to come. Then he will tell you who sent the arrow. You allow the problem to come. Then you did to something through the problem. And the Lord shall tell it. Oh my God. The Lord shall tell it. He shall tell it. Who is the Lord that's going to tell it? Hallelujah. When Joseph allowed himself. Let me tell you this. Joseph had all right to engage in sexual activity with the wife of Pharaoh. She has all right. He has all right. He has the permission. Because the wife said, oh, sleep with me. But Joseph said, no. I have some rules that I'm following.
Yes.
I have something that somebody, the one that told me I'm going to be great, I'm going to feed my family, told me I should not do it. So hey, irrespective of your offer, I wouldn't do it. He allowed God to work on him. So he did not listen to the offer. Now, anytime God's offer is about to be light, the devil will bring the counterfeit one. Anytime, I want you to pay this attention to this. Anytime a great breakthrough is coming, a great miracle is coming, the devil will bring a fake one. You present to the fake one. So if you are not careful, you fall into it. That's going to be the end of your life. But I'm here to announce to you, no matter what the enemy will do, you shall never fall into the traps of the enemy. Shall never fall. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And that time was the next test of Joseph to hate. To become the second in command, there appeared the wife. When Jesus was about to go through the cross and be seated on the right side of God, the devil appeared. He said, eat this bread. Don't worry. I know you are hungry. The Bible says this and that. He said, eat it. Nobody said, just eat small. Jesus said, no. Someone said, no.
No.
If you don't know the word of God, you fall. You fall. You see, you'll be falling into little things. But if you know the word of God and you have allowed God to work on you, when the enemy comes, the reply will come from the word. You will reply the devil and say, do not rejoice over me, over my enemy. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be my light and my salvation. He said, even though when I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no one because the Lord is with me like a mighty warrior. He said, if the Lord is for me, who can be against my life? Oh, hallelujah. Let me tell you that the witches, the powers, those who are working against you, they have already been defeated. Oh my God. So they have been defeated. But let me tell you some secret of the enemy. The devil always start the tribulation to scare you. He will start the tribulation to do what? To scare you of your victory. Someone says, I'm not scared. Let me give this scripture, then maybe we are good to go. Philippians chapter 2, verse 5 to 7. Philippians. Sister, submit to him.
Amen.
Even though you have your own ego, you have your own right, but submit to the Lord.
Amen.
Because two visions and captains can never be the same ones. A lot of marriages can collapse or hit a rock when they become too hesitant. One must allow. It's a choice. One must allow. Even though I have all my rights, but I've allowed you as my leader. I get what I'm saying. So if everybody, nobody wants to allow, like when money falls down and I feel big to pick it for you to also feel big to pick it, the money will be there, you'll be angry. But one must allow. I say, even though when I pick it, it's not going to destroy my life. It's not going to take my beauty from me. It's not going to take my glory out of my life. But rather, it's going to give us food to eat.
Amen.
But if I say, okay, I'm not going to pick it. Like the way this father, Big Papa chose to come and pick it.
Amen.
He can decide to sit. Am I right? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So, you must allow God, even though you have your own life that you want to go out and have some time outside there. You want to go and have some date somewhere. But because you have allowed God to work on you, it stops you.
Amen.
And you can never surrender to God and God will destroy your life. He will not do it. No. He will even prepare you and make you great.
Amen.
David said, I've been an old person. I've never seen the righteous forsaken, neither his children begging for bread. Me, my children are not going to beg for bread. They will be giving bread. Say, my children, they will not beg for bread, but they will be giving bread to people. Because I am a righteous man. Bible says, righteous man does what? Leave an inheritance to his children. A righteous man. Leave. So one of the legacy of a righteous man is to leave something behind. Leave some. Don't just live only for yourself. Don't just care only for your life. You don't care about the future of your children. You are blowing all your money and you don't care about your children. You don't save for them. You don't have any plans for their future. You are destroying them. Praise the Lord. Please read for me. Philippians 2, 5 to 7. God bless you in the name of Jesus. A lot of people have joined us and they are sharing it. They are enjoying the message. I'm telling you. So I am not speaking to you alone. I'm speaking to other people. Sometimes I'm speaking to other people. Are you getting what I'm saying? Philippians 2, 5 to 7. Who is there for me?
Let this mind be in you.
Now, if you want to submit to God, let this mind. Because if you don't have this mind, you cannot submit. If you don't have the mind, this mind I'm going to talk about, you can never serve God. You can even give your tithe. I started, you see, Krista, God has started working something for you.
Amen.
Because you have made a certain decision. Yeah. And that's when you see God in your action.
Yeah.
I get what I'm saying. If you allow God to lead you, he will work it.
Yes.
He has the strength. We can never fight the enemy by our ability. We can't fight the devil with our position. And don't you know that I am Richard, the Prime Minister of Canada? So devil submit to me. No, he said in my name. You can say, I work at the bank. I'm working. I'm this supervisor. So enemy is here. No. I know people who are in charge, but they always, Pastor, somebody's killing my life. I think my people that are behind me, they are taking me to home. Yeah. Pastor, I need prayer. Yes. Let this mind be in you. Which mind do you, what mind do you have? The mind of living things, the mind of unforgiving, the mind of me, I'm not going to accept it. The mind of me, whatever is going to do me, like the mind, you see, they say, a kick mind. When you don't allow God to work on you, it is going to destroy you. I came to a point to realize that no, the power of creativity is in me. The power to make things happen is in me. I have to see the way I think. I get to what I'm saying. Oh, praise the Lord. Let's go, my sister.
So let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ, who being in the form of God,
Jesus,
though it not robbery to be equal with God.
He has the form of God. Jesus could have come and said, hey, me, I don't want anybody to send me. I will not go to the house of Zacchaeus to go eat. I don't care who he is. I am God. So I want you to send me. Jesus was serving the people. Some pastors have mentality that they don't want to send the members. They wonder when they were coming, oh, then they lay down. Are you God? Some people too feel to begin to worship God. When they are worshiping God, they feel big, like they are too big for them to lift up their hands. Like, who are you? Somebody that you have expiry date. When you talk of kingdom, Solomon, look at his kingdom. Where is he now? When you talk of a man that enjoyed women, Solomon was the best. What happened to him? I'm asking the question, what happened to him? He became idol worshiper at the head of the day. He followed women, I followed them to their gods. So at the end of the day, if you see somebody cheating on women, cheating on, brother, you are destroying your life. You are not, you thought you are too smart. You get pregnant, you get a lady pregnant right away. You get right away. You thought you are too smart. One day, you regret it. You'll be crying like a baby boy. I'm telling you. Life, eh? Let us think of our future. Sister, me, I think of my future. I can do whatever I may, you know, so can. But no, I'm thinking of my future. I'm thinking of where I'll go to maybe 80 years, 70 years, where you don't have the strength to be praying, then you have established. No, when everything will collapse. This candle will pop up, this will pop up, everything grind. No, someone say no.
No, no, no.
Someone say no.
No.
Where, when they call you, everybody will stand up and give you applause.
Amen.
God's children is coming. Amen. People look upon you. There are some pastors, when you mention that name, people are sick and tired. You know, even because of them, people don't want to go to church again. Yes, because of some of them, people have given all that they found out that they were giving to wrong holes. So allow God. He said he has the form of God, but he did not thought it equal. Robbery. He said, no, let me come and humble. Washing the feet of the apostles, going after the lost souls. Today, when you see any pastors that are doing evangelism, they say they are not powerful. So pastors has to create impressions. Because people think when they see you on the radio, they see the crowd around your church, they think you have been. So everybody is looking for crowd. So people are led to occultic places and some things to be done to bring the people. Hey, God can use one person to get this around. He can use if you allow him. I'm telling you. If you allow him, you go home and say, let me allow God to work on me. Let me preach something on my mind. I remember when I was in Ghana, I said to myself, every Sunday I will send someone to church. I built the church. Even though I was under my senior pastor. So one day my senior pastor went to, like, you know, suspend me. Because at times I went here, I like to move around. And the members say, Pastor, if you dare do it, we are all going to leave. All the people that are sitting, I went out and bring them. So when my senior pastor here, he said, hey, oh, they call me. He said, Kwaku, how? Don't do that again. I said, okay. Yes. Someone say, yes.
Yes.
I get what I'm saying. Jesus, how he submitted to authority. You could have come and said, I want people to worship me as well. If you want to see me pay this amount of money, I wrote on my faith with that. I don't believe that if you're going to see a pastor, you have to pay money. Why? Why? Praise the Lord. So you have to even go through security checks. I'm telling you, you are more than going through immigration airport. They will check you, go here, somebody will go to a room, you see. Because the power is not there anymore. The power that God, you see, when you begin to rely on the physical things, you lose the power of God. Fear begin to grip you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, praise the Lord. My last scripture. Let me give this scripture that I'll be end for the day. Amen.
Amen.
I want to finish this message.
Amen.
Maybe you are the people God wanted to listen.
Amen.
And I'm so glad for you. Amen.
Amen.
John chapter 5 verse 6. After this, I will just end the message. John chapter 5 verse 6. God bless you. Those who have joined me, God bless you in the name of Jesus. The book of John chapter 5 verse 6. I want someone to read. Then after this, I'm going to declare over your life. And I want to see a change.
Amen.
Allow him. That if I can get this, I need to allow God to work on me. Okay, then let me allow God to work on me. When my allow God, he come. Look at sister, when you started coming to Friday prayer, you see what God is doing in your life.
Amen.
And he's going to do more. You don't know what God is about to do.
Amen.
Things that grows beautiful must go through the grounds and die.
Amen.
Jesus has to go through the end, die for 3 days and come back triumphantly.
My God, thank you, Lord.
So with this, we are going through our plantation time. Oh, hallelujah. I have seen the future.
Amen.
As I have done what? Have you also seen the future?
Oh, yes.
Papa, have you seen the future?
Oh, yes.
Christ, have you seen the future?
Amen.
Is it Kamel? Have you seen the future?
Yes.
Read for me. Those who have seen the future, they don't give up. Those who have seen the promised land, they don't give up on the rest. They don't allow the rest to stop them. Because we are going to the promised land. And very soon, this is a confirmation. The Lord is about to turn this around. Oh, my God. The Lord, a time is coming. I'll be preaching here and CNN, BBC. They'll be taking my preaching live. is what God have told me.
Go ahead.
So I will not allow the rest to stop me from Makeda. I will not allow Pharaoh to draw me back again. I will never allow the giant on my miracle, my land, to scare me. They are evil giants on this land. They just try to scare people. We are not scared. When God wants to do something, he already has finished the battle for you. I'm telling you, he knows. So he has prepared me. I get what I'm saying. He has prepared me. I have gone through my wilderness. I have gone through my desert time. It's time for my pastors. So when people are throwing their arrows, they throw their bullet. You see, when they come, it hit my body and return back again. Oh, hallelujah. Say back to the sender. Say it's a return back. They are doing everything they can. But if God is the starter, he will also be the finisher. The Lord that has begun with my life, the same God has the power to accomplish it. Don't give up. Don't give up. They'll come and fight you. They'll try and tell you to stop. They'll try and come to you, prove to you sovereignty. But don't give up.
Never give up.
It's better you lose a friend to serve God that to gain a friend to lose God. Can I repeat again?
Yes.
It's better. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you. See him and just give it a sign that this is for him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's better. Do you come with your camera? Okay. It's better to lose a friend to gain God than to have a friend to lose your maker.
Amen.
Someone say, talk to me.
Talk to me.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Please, let's go.
When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he said unto him,
Jesus,
wilt thou be made whole?
Now, why should Jesus ask him that question? Bible said Jesus knew the man has been there for what? So many long. So Jesus think, okay, I cannot just heal you. Maybe you are enjoying to be at the pulpit pastor. Maybe you are just a presenter. They are using you to give report. Don't you know that some people are something, not because they want their thing to grow, but they are doing reports, giving daily activities. And you know that people go to people's wedding, not because they love your wedding, no. They want to see how things went, even the food, or the makeups, or look at the shoe. You could have worn this shoe. That is why they are there. So that they will go, oh, the food was not good at all. Oh, don't you know that the dressing was no good? You couldn't see that there was something here.
Yes.
Some people can watch what it means, your dot point here. Yes. And we should have make up it. So they came purposely to watch. So Jesus asked the man, do you want to be made whole? Because I cannot come and heal you. I cannot come and take you from that position. Maybe you are enjoying it. So give me permission.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Give me permission and I'll work it on you. Jesus said, do you want? The man started talking. He said, I have no one. Jesus said, no, that was not the question. I said, do you want to walk? Do you want to be whole again? The man started talking. So the man has issues. He said, I have no one. I said, do you believe? He said, yes. Then, so Jesus bathed and said, then rise up, take up your mats and walk. So you can only rise up when you allow him. You can only rise up to the top when you allow God to work on you. You can only rise up to the higher level if you allow God to work in your life.
Yes.
Amen.
We have to allow God to work. We can resist God's miracle by what we have inside our mind, our heart, our soul. We can resist it. But if you have clear conscience, good heart, I'm telling you, God will work through it and lift us in this place. May the Lord bless you. May your doors be open.
Amen.
I prophesy over your life. Anything that you are going through, may you allow him to work it for you. I pray that anything that battles your mind, that challenges your life, I curse it in the mighty name of Jesus. And I prophesy the favor of God over your life. And I declare that you never fall into the trap of the devil. The Lord shall lead you. And the Lord shall protect you. In Jesus' name I pray. Let the people of God say amen. Oh, pray together for Jesus.